Hey guys, today we're going to be doing a replacement of the shell on my DJI Phantom 3 Professional here. This thing has gotten into a bit of a wreck and has messed up, particularly this side of the shell here is all beaten up. I'm actually missing that little thing that covers the lights, and it's all crashed right there, cracked. I've already taken the stickers and the little emblem off of it. So anyhow, I'll go ahead and show you what all I have as replacement parts for this thing. I'm also going to be replacing the motors because... Alright, I'm going to replace the motors because those things took quite a bit of a beating. They're all scratched up. I don't think that really affects their performance, but it might throw them out of balance. And with my luck, one of the shafts is probably bent. And... I'd end up having to buy new motors anyway, so I've got the two motors there. These are the new style ones. So anyhow, I'll set these aside for now. I've got a set of props. I only really messed up one prop, but I'll replace them all anyway. And underneath this is the actual body. Haven't actually taken this out of the box yet, so. And yes, there is the new body for it. Fairly lightweight there. We've got, it's like a bag of screws. And it feels like there. So we've got landing gear in this box. Yeah, so we have both pieces of landing gear that we can replace as well, but my landing gear isn't actually damaged anyway, might as well replace it. Anyway, that's all the parts. We'll go ahead and start taking the Phantom apart and putting it back together, I suppose, after that. So, let's get to it. Alright, so here's the Phantom again. I've also went out and picked up some Torx screwdriver bits here. So, anyhow, these are really long ones because there is one screw on each one of these arms that's actually buried down in there quite far, which is that one right there. But what I'm going to do here, my plan, I'm going to take out all the screws that hold the body together first. And then I'm going to take off the landing gear, the camera assembly here, light bridge, or not light bridge, but VPS. And then I'm going to pop the shell apart. Now, the reason why I'm doing it in that particular order, if you're wondering, is when we take the landing gear off, you're going to have some antennas that are just going to be flopping around here. So... And when those antennas are flopping around, if you have these little tiny, I think they're like coax cables that are going into them, I don't want those to break off. So I'm going to try to minimize the amount of time I've got A, antennas flopping around, and B, open electronics on the top of this thing. So I'm going to start off just taking out all these screws that hold the arms together. Alright, so let me introduce you to camera angle number two. I've got another camera set up over here, which I'm going to use as like a time-lapse thing, but figured I'd mention I've got just some magnets here, and I've got plenty more of these laying around. But I'm going to use these to hold the screws in one place, and I'll probably take some sticky notes and just put one magnet on one sticky note. I've got a nice empty spot over here on my desk, and I'll just label what the screw is and stick it on the magnet and leave it there. So, anyhow, that's kind of the plan. So, I'm going to go ahead and start, I'm just going to go all the way around getting these first little tiny outer screws, which are T6 Torx bits. These bits that I have, I should mention, are the security type bit, and they have little holes drilled in the center of them.
You don't really need that type of bit, but it's just a standard Torx T6, and these other ones are T8. And there's also somewhere you'll need some metric Allen wrenches to get to, like the motor mount screws, and I think the ones on this little VPS module are actually like that too. And I think there's also like Phillips on like this GPS antenna cover. So there's quite a few different types of screws, which brings in the labeling system. So anyhow, go ahead and start taking this thing apart. Alright, so those screws are taken out. I do believe the rest of the screws that are on these arms are T8s. So I'll grab the next bit that I need here, and I'm just going to take out all the screws, like the ones that are right behind the motor here, and also the ones that are in those quite long holes there. So go ahead and do that.
Alright, so far I've taken out all the screws on the arms. So this screw, these two screws, and that screw on every arm. And you notice basically three different locations, and I have three different types of screws so far. So the next thing that I'll work on is getting this landing gear off of here. And I'm probably thinking to take the antennas out before I take the actual landing gear off. And it looks like these are just going to pop out of here, so like a press fit type thing. So I'll probably try to get the antennas off first and then take the landing gear off, and then we'll work on getting the camera and gimbal assembly off of here. So let's get to it. So I thought I'd show this quick here. In order to get these off of here, what I'm finding is to take the screwdriver, just a flathead screwdriver, and kind of wedge it in behind right in this area here and just pry that out. And you'll hear the thing popping and things, but of course it's clipped in here, so you'd expect that. So yeah, just get your screwdriver in here and wedge that out. Pretty easy, really. The only other one that there is the compass antenna, and that's got like a little cover over it, and I've been told that that's actually glued on. So the antenna in there is actually glued on, the cover's just screwed on, but anyhow, yeah, I'll get the rest of these antennas off, and we'll see how it goes.
Alright, so at this point, just getting the landing gear off of here. I haven't gotten the compass out yet because that's going to be a bit tricky. It is glued in there pretty darn good, so I'm just going to take this stuff off first and then work on the compass. And these antennas should just feed right through there.
Alright, so the landing gear has been taken off of this thing. The little compass, that is a real pain in the butt to get out of there. It looks like it's okay. So hopefully it is. It looks fine. It was in that little spot there with the glue. And just a bit of a fun fact here: those screws that hold the little piece of plastic onto the compass there, those are actually stainless steel screws, and they will not stick to a magnet. So there you go. Just a little bit of an interesting fact there. Should give you some idea how sensitive that little compass thing is. So anyhow, that took a bit of careful cutting and working at it, and I ended up just kind of pushing up on the board, and the thing just slipped out of the glue, really. Anyhow, it looks okay. Like I said, hopefully it is. So I've got all the landing gear off of this. Next thing, I'll take this camera off, which you got these anti-drop pin things and just a couple connectors that are underneath this. I think these anti-drop things are probably just going to have to get cut. So anyhow, go ahead and do that next.
Alright, so with the anti-drop kit, I do have a spare one, so I'm thinking these are probably just going to have to get cut, unfortunately, because I don't think there's any real way to get them things off, unfortunately, so just cut that off and get the gimbal off of here. Of course, get a new anti-drop kit, but there isn't a spare one included. And to be quite honest with you, I think you could probably just loosely wrap a zip tie around these things in order to make your own sort of anti-drop kit. But go ahead and squeeze these little rubber deals and they should just kind of come off. Should be able to pull those through pretty easy. And underneath this thing, there are a couple of connectors that will have to be carefully removed. One of these, I think, is a locking connector, and one isn't. Yeah. So this connector toward the back of the gimbal there, that one can just be pulled out, which actually doesn't even fit in there all that tight. This other one is a locking connector and will have to be very carefully squeeze that little thing and pull out on it at the same time, which might be a bit of a trick. There we go. Alright, so we got the two connectors out there. This is the camera itself here, camera and gimbal assembly. You got the top motor, just the two connectors, and a little tiny fan. So, anyhow. That's that. Set this off to the side. And this plate will also have to come off, so I might as well do that too. You don't really need to take these off of here for any reason. And now it looks like we're starting to get into things that use Allen wrenches. So we got another type of fastener. Alright, so with all the screws out of that, we should just be able to lift this up. And there we are. This is the little gimbal mounting plate thing. It's just as a piece of silver plastic. So I'll set that over by the gimbal. Under here we had a cable that kind of ran this way. These were both connected into the gimbal. This one curiously has a little ferrite bead on it there. apparently to keep it from interfering with something. So the next thing I guess I'll get off is the light bridge board if I can. I might actually be better off at this point taking the shell off, but I'm gonna go ahead and get the light bridge guy off of here. Let's see what's under here. Alright, so I've gotten the screws removed off of the vision positioning system cover here. And it looks like I got a cable that needs to be unhooked. There, and that is just going to slide out, looks like. Yep, there we go. So, I'm sorry, I keep calling this thing the light bridge, but it's a vision positioning system. So I apologize for that, just my goof-ups there, but... Anyway, that thing's off. Looks like we have a circuit board. How interesting. There is a little push button switch there, which, yeah, I guess you can get those of that from that on the outside of it. It may have been a better idea to get the shell off first, as I was kind of thinking before. But that's what I'm going to have to work on next, is getting the shell pried off, I believe. So, let's see how this comes apart. Okay, so we're finally about there. I need to pull this connector out here where the GPS module attaches to it. And slide this off. There we go. So this is the top half. It's got the little GPS in it. Probably did some minor damage to this case as I was opening it up, but... probably in okay shape still. Then again, this arm is about ready to fall off anyway. So, yeah. Go ahead, and I believe I'm gonna have to take all this stuff out. I might just, I can probably just stick this back over it and let that cover up those electronics there while I work on getting this stuff out of here. And what I'm thinking I'm going to do is probably, since I'm going to replace the motors anyway, I'm probably going to desolder these and get them out of here. Then get just everything out. I'll take a picture of this so I know what wires are. Actually, you know what? They're marked on the circuit board anyway. It doesn't really matter. But these wires are held down with more of this glue stuff. So a little bit more careful surgery cutting those off. And yeah, I'll desolder those. I got my soldering iron back here. So I'll go ahead and start working on that. Alright, so now I have desoldered these motors. I've gotten some of the glue out of the way, at least enough of it to be able to solder on new ones. And next I gotta get these LED boards out of here, and it looks like they've just sort of mounted them onto posts and then melted the backs of the posts down onto the board. So I think those will be pretty easy to actually cut off. Just with side cutters or something like that. Let's actually see if I can get one of these out there. Just be a bit tricky to get down in here though.
Alright, so I give you an idea of where we're at now. I've got all these LED boards removed. And curiously, all these LED boards are actually the same. They all have three wires coming from them, which would mean that they are most likely all red-green LEDs. So in other words, the LEDs in the front, at least in theory, should have the ability to turn green as well. So, just found that kind of interesting. Maybe a firmware update could fix that. But looking at our circuit board here, you'll notice that the thing is conformally coated, which means that it, in theory, is a little bit more water resistant than a normal circuit board. And it's basically just coated in like an enamel paint type thing. It's clear. Anyhow, you see the motor driver circuitry here, and they also have it looks like current sense resistors, which would be what gives you the indication when your motors are obstructed. If you've ever gotten one of these motors hit by something, that's you get a motor obstructed error, and that's probably what lets the microcontroller or whatever and this thing know that the motor has been stopped, because one of these resistors, or all of them, will be dropping a lot more voltage across it because it's drawing more current. So anyhow, all the motors have been desoldered. I've cleaned up the glue. This thing right here is probably all the circuitry to the IMU, all the gyroscopes and all that kind of stuff here. Like all this around here would be the motor driver circuitry, and there's not a whole lot else to it. The top part had the GPS module. So now I'll take, looks like we got four screws that are holding this board in. I'll take that out, and I'll get the little VPS sensor off the bottom of this, and it'll be pretty much taken apart.
Alright, so I believe we are ready to pull this board out of here. Hopefully I got a couple connectors over here actually that will need to be pulled. There we go. There might be more on the bottom. There's actually more over here as well, and this one's glued in. That's kind of odd there. This one's actually glued, so. Okay, so that one's actually a little bit of a trick. It's actually a locking connector, but the lock is behind the wires on it, so. Anyhow, hopefully that's all of those things. so you got the battery connector down there. And that's got a Phillips screw on it. And there is the circuit board freed from its plastic prison here. So we've still got plenty more stuff, I'm sure, to get out of this. So I'll continue working on it here. We're actually getting into the home stretch of disassembly though, so that's quite nice. Alright, so next thing I'm going to take out is this little battery holder here, and that's I'm pretty sure I have to keep this piece, otherwise the new one doesn't actually come with it. So alright, so I got the little battery cage thing out. Get this little USB port. And USB port cover is, yeah, that's probably in the case area. You probably don't have to worry about that guy, but yeah, we get the USB port out of here. Alright, so now it's basically a matter of getting all of the antennas and everything else ran out of here. And it might be a bit tricky. Just getting all the cables through. You can probably start with pushing the antennas up through here, because the little board that's underneath of this has the connectors for the antennas on it. So alright, so here I'm just thinking probably take this entire thing off. So I'll go ahead and pull this up. Looks like plenty of wires that could get caught and mangled in bad ways, so we most certainly want to be really careful with this. Alright, so the last thing I'm going to take out of this is the motors. And I didn't really want to have to disconnect all the antennas and stuff like that, but unfortunately two of them did have to come off. And I put a little black dot on the back of one of these to mark that was antenna number one on the board. So two of the antennas are still attached. A couple of them had to come off. I've got a couple of ribbon cables that we'll have to go back on. And the antennas there, and this little board.
So pretty much all the electronics are out of this thing. And now I just got the motors left. And then I've got to put it all back together, which will be the hard part, of course. Alright, so it's pretty much all taken apart, and this is all that's left of it. I would like to point out, though, that these things actually have metal threaded inserts for at least most of the screws, which is pretty nice. Anyhow, the really busted up arm was this one, as you can see, in pretty bad shape. So, anyhow, the next step is to put it back together again. And I just about forgot about this, but we have to take the GPS off the top part of the case here. Alright, so we pulled out quite a number of parts at this point. I've got, let's see here, 14 different kinds of screws. I've got another magnet over here I haven't quite labeled yet. Don't worry, I'm getting to work on that. I'll actually probably just put the GPS in first. But anyhow, all these screws, you got this part of a vision positioning system. Little battery cage and all these things, which I've just kind of scribbled a label onto. We got the actual main circuit board here. I do believe this has something to do with light bridge here, but not sure about that. This is a piece of copper shielding tape that was underneath the GPS, or on top of the GPS, I suppose. And then I've got the camera here. So far this entire process have taken about 2.5 hours. Granted, I've been filming this and doing that kind of stuff with it as well, so it's probably taking a little bit longer. I've got the motors over here too, which, like I said, I'm going to replace the motors, so anyhow, let's go ahead and get on with taking the new shell apart and putting this thing back together. Alright, so the next thing that needs to be done is I need to take the new shell apart, and they ship this to you with, well, it ships pre-assembled, which is actually kind of an unfortunate thing. But also, I forgot to mention that little, I didn't think that you'd need the little USB port cover that goes up on the front here, but you do, so that thing just pulls off. So. You didn't need that, and this thing should come apart just by kind of squeezing the bottom together and working around, so go ahead and see if I can get this apart. Alright, so unfortunately I'm not really able to get this on camera very good, but I am slowly working away at this. You'll see that pretty much wedging screwdrivers in there to keep these things pulled apart, in order to I'll keep them from snapping back together, but basically just pushing in really hard on these things until they pop out like that. And you're pushing in on this bottom piece, and that will release the little lugs that are holding that in. So it's kind of difficult, and that's why I'm not really being able to get this on camera too well. So I'll keep working away at this, and I'll come back when I've got this thing opened up. Alright, so now that this has all been taken apart,
go ahead and install our GPS module. One thing that you'll notice about most of this stuff is they've got it set up so that you can only put it in here one way. Like for example, these holes aren't like evenly spaced out, and also there is a shielded can there that they can't put a hole through, but the like the camera and this little VPS board are set up like that, so you can't put them in the wrong way. So yeah, that'll line up like that, and we'll start putting screws back in. Alright, so the GPS has been stuck back into place on the new top. And I'll go ahead and set that aside. The next thing I'll do, pretty much just doing this in reverse order, we will mount in our new motors, which I'll go ahead and grab. So I'll set this to the side for now. Got new motors, all new motors, and like these actually are still in pretty good shape. That one looks like it's brand new. Actually got a bit of a grinding sound to it. I think three of these are actually in pretty much perfect condition, but one of these has gotten scratched up a bit. Probably don't really need to replace them, but I'm going to anyway. Keep these old ones as spares. Alright, so now we'll go ahead and start with putting these motors in. We'll start with the clockwise motor, which would be the one with the black dot. And that's going to go up into the top left corner here, the front left.
Well, I actually just found a micro SD card in the back of this. This is presumably for the firmware. So, anyhow, that's kind of interesting. I had to take this whole thing apart again because this cable needs to be flipped around the other direction. And in order to do that, I have to take everything out because everything is in the way of this cable, unfortunately. So, yeah, this has to be flipped over 180 degrees, so... Anyway, figured I'd show you the little SD card that's mounted on the back of the main flight board here. Alright, so I've got the electronics put back into here. I did originally try to melt the little plastic peg things back down, but I ended up just hot gluing them. And I put hot glue over the spots where there used to be that white glue stuff that was holding down the wires. So it's pretty much put back together in terms of this part. I just got to get the camera mounted back on the bottom. And the landing gear stuck back on it, so go ahead and do that next. Well, it's pretty much back together. The top's not on yet, and I still have to do like the anti-drop kit and that kind of stuff. But this last piece here with the compass put up quite a fight getting the wires in, so I ended up gluing them to the side of the antenna and slipping them in there. There's now a bulge where that isn't flush anymore. And, just kind of sucks in this. That's not flush anymore either because that was glued in a different spot this time around, but well, it's all close enough. I'm going to put the top on this thing. Well, I'm just going to lay it on it and hook up the GPS sensor, and I'll stick a battery in it, see if everything works. Then I'll put like the feet and the anti-drop kit on the gimbal and that kind of stuff. Alright, so here we go. I got the top stuck back on. Throw a battery in here. That seems to work. Get our controller power. And I think that beep might be because it's a little bit low on power, but I'm not real sure about that. Hopefully. Well, the gimbal's doing something. Is it actually working though? Emma, there we go. Aircraft warming up. It's working. So I'll get this put back together the rest of the way, and someday go and do a test flight. It's really cold and windy right now, so I can't really do much with it. But anyhow, I'll put it back together the rest of the way. Alright, so we give this thing one more test. remote on. Maybe. Safe to fly on GPS. We gotta see if this actually starts the motors. It is actually running. And make sure that's spinning that way. Yeah, that's right. Never mind. That's right. That's right. Alright, these are all spinning the right way according to the little arrows on here. You can tell it's trying to stabilize it when I'm... kind of amazing how fast that thing reacts to that little tiny movement. You can kind of hear it there. But now, I gotta put the stickers back on it. So, that seems to work. So I put the stickers back on here. Some new ones. Luckily, they actually give you another set of gold stickers, and now never really understood why before, but now I do. And I'm not getting very good GPS reception, but I do have it. Of course, I'm inside, so can't complain too much. Alright, so I'm gonna get the IMU calibrated now. So if we go into the camera view here, maybe get rid of that, go into here, and then sensors, and hit IMU calibration, and please keep the aircraft stationary and horizontal. We'll say okay to that, and pretty much just says you to do that again. Now it says IMU calibration in progress, please wait. Alright, so now we have IMU calibration okay. I should be able to check the IMU. And calibration is not required, so that's alright. And I'll also go into here and do a gimbal calibration too, since it's here. Start it, do something. There we go. Gimbal calibration complete. Okay. So that's pretty much it, except for the compass calibration, which I'll have to go outside for. As you can see, I just complained about the compass being out there, so... Alright, so here we are with the test flight. I've gone through and I've calibrated the compass already, so... see what we get. First thing I'm gonna test is just see if it hovers in one spot. There's not a whole lot of wind here, so seems to be doing that just fine. It appears like everything's working. I'm not sure if I can get this in any spot out here where it's going to go into the optical sensor, but I can drop it down here and see if it does. But anyhow, it at least appears to be fixed. That's it for now, guys. Bye.